Hey, welcome back to the Zepril channel, hanging out here in the Zepril hangar for another edition of the album and the concert, talking about King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard 2023 release, their 24th album, and the concert I attended here at the Salt Shed. They did a 3-night sold out run, and I want to talk about it, get into it, and share some clips I have from the show and talk about their new album. Straight out of the box, I have to admit, this is my first King Gizzard album I bought. I've known about the band. I've heard VC people talk about the band. I might have, you know, checked a couple stuff online on the band, but I never really dove into them. So when they announced that they were coming to town for 3 shows, I was like, well, let me go check this band out. And I usually like to go see stuff live, sometimes before I even know it. I mean, that's, you know, I like to discover artists, bands and stuff. Live, you know, I've done that where you kind of discover like an opening band and all of a sudden they kind of blow you. So I'm like, well, you know what? You know, it can't be bad. I've heard, like I said, I you know, sampled some music here and there. So I figured, oh, I'll check it out. And actually, I mean, looking back, I had the opportunity to get tickets for all 3 shows because when they went on sale, I was in there right away, but I decided to go in the last show. But on June 16th, they released their album, Petrodragonic Apocalypse, or The Dawn of Eternal Life, The Annihilation of Planet Earth, and The Beginning of the Merciless Damnation. That's a heck of a title, my friends, but I guess they are known for putting some long titles. So this came out, a 2-album set, June 16, 2023, about 3 days after the concert, actually. Again, though, I didn't go in and sample any of this stuff. I was looking at some of the older stuff. And now, you know, obviously what I've learned through other VC members and just sampling, that it's like every other album or so, they do different styles. They've done like jazz fusion. This is a really a progressive, like a metal album. I mean, it's pretty thrashy at parts, and it's a heavy metal album for them. But they've done, you know, like I said, some jazz style stuff, progressive rock kind of stuff, just different kind of styles. And this one, obviously, I was like, okay, well, anytime I'm gonna go see these guys, this will be the show, you know, the time when they're doing this, and pick up this record. So. I picked this up from my local shop, Bucket of Blood Records, and definitely really enjoying this. This is the Lucky Rainbow Wax on KGLW Records. And what else over here? King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard. Comes in this little slip case. So you take that out, and it just has this awesome artwork here. Love that. And it's you can see it's a little textured on the cover, so the lizard and everything, the Gila, and the smoke and everything fits in there. And this is a concept album. I don't know if all their albums have been concept, but this definitely is a concept album. There's a story to it, and then you know, basically, you know, it's a story of how us humans are like just destroying the earth with pollution and everything. And how the lizard or the Gila grows by consuming humans and helping try to save the planet. And it's the next rise in the evolution of who's gonna, you know, inhabit this earth. And it seems like the lizards are gonna take it over, or are gonna take it back from the dinosaurs. You know, remember the dinosaurs, right? All right, so anyway, yeah, going through this, man, it's just a fun listen, hard rock and stuff. You know, they got, look at that, man, they did the old kind of death metal kind of stuff, even though you can read that one on the logo. But yeah, man, this is a great set. Power cuts on this first, on the first 3 sides. This last side is spoken word and basically telling the whole story there. So it was cool to listen to. Here it comes in these slip cases with lyrics on them, and just really enjoying this. Now, like I said, this said the Lucky Rainbow Wax. Well, mine is just kind of green. I mean, I don't see what I mean by rainbow, but both of my albums are green with some little streaks of white in there. You know, not that it matters. Sounds really good. Nice clean copy of vinyl, and I've been rocking this since I got it last week. I just recently got it because my store had a delay on the order. I mean, these things, I guess, sold out in pre-orders. So by the time my store got it, it was mid last week. In fact, when I went to go pick this up, I was with Michael Pilmer. And if you catch my last video, we had a meetup. He came up from North Carolina. And if you go to the live stream, you'll see a live stream we did. But yeah, I picked this up last week when Michael Pilmer was in town, and just been playing it since. Just loving it, man. Moto Spirit, just killer tractor. Gila Mantra is my favorite right now, just because, and you'll see in the live version there. And I guess Dragon's like a new video they put out. If I can find that, I'll put all kinds of stuff in the description box for you. But really, really digging this album. Like I said, this is their 24th album. They've been a band since about 2010, from what I understand. And I think they release like a couple of albums a year. In fact, I think in 2017, they released 5 albums. It's unreal, man. And to try to catch up with this catalog, I'm not going to even attempt it, man. I'll probably scope out a couple different albums. You know, like I said, if they're pretty kind of different on styles, I'll have to kind of see what I like. But this one, I had no brainer, man. I'm just going to get this one. Definitely after seeing the show, it was a no brainer. But even before the show, when I heard some of the songs, you know, what I heard online, I think it was Gila when they released that video. I was like, oh, okay, I'm definitely going to get this. So, yeah, man, check this out, man. The album is Petro Dragonic Apocalypse or The Dawn of Eternal Night, the Annihilation of Planet Earth, and The Beginning of the Merciless Damnation. Hell of a title, dude. So, yeah, great, great album. I'm really into it, really enjoying it. So then let's talk about, I'm going to get into the concert a little. It was at, like I said, the Salt Shed, which is the old Morton Salt building. And I'll throw a picture right here. It's the old Morton Salt warehouse that they revented, you know, gutted it out. And the main warehouse is now a concert venue inside. And I've seen a few shows there now. But this time they had the show out on the loading dock area where they, you know, you can have a bunch of food trucks and everything like that. So that was really cool. It was interesting though, it was raining. As you can tell, I'm wearing that hood over my head. It was kind of raining and stuff. But the show was going to go on. Now, I couldn't figure out why they just didn't. It was raining, I think, the night before too, at the second night show. I don't know why they just didn't move it inside, but then again, as the show went on, I kind of noticed a lot of smoke coming up, so I figured they might have just said, you know, we're going to keep this outside, and they hired all the food trucks and stuff. I don't know. They could have done that. You know, they could have moved it inside anyway, but it was a rainy, cloudy day. I mean, it was pouring at some points where I had to, you know, I had to buy a raincoat. So, yeah, this is me in the raincoat. So yeah, I had to buy a raincoat, and so yeah, the King Gizzard comes to the Salt Shed for 3 shows, sold out shows, and now that I think about it, I think I remember reading that the Salt Shed's capacity, the actual warehouse shed, is about 3,000 people, and I think the loading dock's about 5,000 people, so maybe that's why they didn't move it inside. I don't know, but it was pouring rain in Chicago. That day, I mean, it was heavy set points, man. And then, and the loading dock had, like I said, there were like food trucks and stuff. They had their merch tent in the back. So I got about, I don't know, I want to say, I don't know, maybe 35 or so people back from the, I was in front of the soundboard and stuff. So wasn't too close, but yeah, not too far back. So, but anyway, here's the ticket from the show, the old mobile tickets, general admission show. But focus in there, but you get the gist. So yeah, man, I was already, you know, psyched up to see it. Rain's coming down. I'm thinking, man, are they gonna cancel? There's a guy up there sweeping or pushing water off the stage, and he's getting cheers, like people are cheering him on. So yeah, they take the stage, and it just started just rocking it, man. So I'm going to share a clip with you. This is doing Gila Monster from the new album. And here's the Australian band King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard live at Salt Shed. Check out this clip. Sorry about that, guys. Get excited. So yeah, you could tell, man, the energy was just off the hook. And I was getting all into it. I was like, this is great. I got a lot of cool people around me. And I guess, I don't know, I might have been a little farther back than I thought. I guess, I don't know, I was just, when I watched that clip again. But it wasn't too bad. But yeah, I mean, people just bouncing everybody. I mean, it was just weird, just all into it, getting it. There's like six guys on, yeah, band of six, I think. And everybody was just killer too, watching them, you know. So then, yeah, then I remember people had like lizard puppets and stuff, which was pretty cool. And then, you know, the pit started kind of circling. So here's another clip. You can see some of the people kind of circling and stuff. So kind of step back a little, but not too much. I didn't get involved in that. But I mean, the rain's coming down and still not too heavy, but you know, it was getting a little more clear at night. So you'll notice some people start taking their hoods off and stuff. But here's another clip, King Gizzard live at the Salt Shed. You can see the crowd just getting into it real quick, man. Just going crazy, man. And I mean, I wasn't, like I said, I didn't get into the whole mosh pits or circles, but I was just having a blast, man. It was just a good time. I remember when I walked in, man, the merch line was like super long, you know. And I was like, I wasn't really, and I saw the t-shirt designs, and there was maybe one or two that I might have liked, but I didn't get a t-shirt or anything. There's a tie-dye one and a lot of colors, and I'm not really, I like a lot of, you know, like black t-shirts, but, the guy saying, wearing his, Salt Shed, yellow raincoat, but, But the merch line was like super long, you know. I was like, I wasn't gonna get it. I mean, I got enough t-shirts, right? So, but then after the show, I'm walking by the merch tent and there's like two people there. And I'm like, oh, well, let me run up. And sure enough, man, I saw the poster, the show poster. And I was like, okay, I'll snag that. I think it was like 40 bucks maybe. So I snagged the show poster. And I thought it was pretty cool. It had the, it was like a little short tour they were doing, at least for this poster. This covered the shows in Tennessee and Grundy County. They did a series at the Red Rocks in outside of Denver. The three Chicago shows, Washington State show, and then a show at the Hollywood Bowl. But what I liked about this, man, I like the little lizard guys. It was a pretty cool poster. So it had like, you know, Tennessee and Colorado. Here's the Red Rocks. Here's the little lizards there. And then here's just outside of Seattle and Washington State. And then here in Chicago, they're at the Salt Shed and they're shoveling salt. See the little lizard shoveling salt? So I bought this poster. And, you know, it was cool. It had the dates on it and everything. Yeah. Snagged out right when I went out. They had a little, like a plastic bag that it was rolled in. Kind of tuck it underneath the raincoat here. Tuck it right in there. And went home, man. And I wasn't expecting to do that, but I thought it was a cool poster, and I had to get it. Anybody knows me? That's what I do. So I really enjoyed it, man. It was a great show. Really turned on to these guys. I probably will see them again in the future. I'm definitely gonna check out some of their other albums. But the album and the concert, oh, great, man. Really good album. Check this album out if you guys haven't already. Like I said, I'm newbie. Transparency here, man. It's just this is my I'll say my intro, because you know, just kind of skimming music online doesn't really count. So this is my intro. This actually can go for the first one, the One You Never Forget series that I do. So King Gizzard's Petrodragnonic Apocalypse, or The Dawn of the Eternal Night and Annihilation of Planet Earth and the Beginning of the Merciless Damnation album, 2023 release, and in the concert at the Salt Shed here in Chicago. They did, three shows, the 11th, 12th, and 13th. I went to June 13th, and that's it. I'll leave you with another clip. This is it's about 2 minutes. They're just jamming here, man, just wailing on stuff. I mean, I don't know the name of the song. If you do know the name of the song, stick it in the comments, let me know. But they're just jamming out. I mean, they're a jam band, but they did it metal style, so it was pretty cool today. So thanks for tuning in, everybody, hanging out here in the hangar, and checking out the album, the concert with King Gizzard and Lizard Wizard. Check out this clip. Thanks for tuning in.